I attempted to fix it. But let me explain. I'm trying to repair it as it is, at 20 inches. This is so annoying. We'll detach one spoke for spoke replacement. In reality, Dr.Road is lazy. This is a major project because the spokes are too short. We fabricated a wrench by processing a spanner. We're just going to give up and cut all the spokes. No way. Using a grinder to cut it is insane. I found the missing tool. It's so simple. Cutting the spokes closer to the hub makes it easier to separate them. We've cut all the spokes. We're currently removing all the spokes. This is heavy. It's heavy because it's a 500 watts hub motor. Spoke length calculation. The hub is 135 millimeters in length for the OLD. (35.5 millimeters) for the non-drive side to the flange.
Non-drive side to flange.
(50 millimeters) for the drive side to the flange.
Drive side to flange.
143 millimeters for the flange non-drive side diameter.
Non-drive side flange diameter. Drive side flange diameter.
Flange drive side diameter is unknown. If the hub is too big, this is also acceptable. Cut a piece of paper. Mark the distance between the farthest holes with a pen. This can also be used when measuring axle length. Measure the flange diameter using a caliper. 143 millimeters. The dropout axle measurement method is as follows. Measure with a sturdy paper, cutting it little by little several times to make it easier. It's 135 millimeters.
Hub axle width.
Effective rim diameter or measurement method. Install the spoke nipple on the spoke. We're ready. Put it on the rim for a moment. Mark it with a marker pen. Take it off now. We'll use vernier calipers. We have measured 3.5 millimeters. This is the easiest method for measuring erd. Measuring the inner diameter of the rim becomes much easier. Erd equals 3.5 by 2 plus inner rim diameter. Add 7 millimeters to it. This is the best way to measure it. Find the valve hole. Start the measurement from the valve hole. 575 millimeters plus 7 millimeters. The inner diameter is 575 millimeters.
Effective rim diameter.
36 holes equals 18 by 2.
Number of spokes. 스포크 레이싱 패턴.
Order the spokes.
스포크를 주문하러 갑니다.
Accept click. Calculate click. Spoke length calculation is complete. Spoke installation. This wheel utilizes the cross pattern, which is the standard method of inserting spokes into the flange by alternating left and right. If the motor is very large, cross is impossible. Next, we will check the sequence for installing the spokes. First step, flange. A. Fit the spoke inwards from the outside. Please do this first. Please do it the same way. The first thing to find is the valve hole. Please mark it like this. Assemble one by one starting from the valve hole. Install the first spoke in the hole next to the valve. Three hole jump. This is a pattern of jumping over three holes. This pattern remains the same regardless of the number of spoke holes. It's also the same for a 20 hole pattern. It's heavy. Be careful not to break the wire when flipping it. Please put it on the floor. Work with the same pattern. Second step, flange. B. Fit the spoke inwards from the outside. Be careful not to cut the wire. Attach it to the spoke next to the one you initially installed. Install it like this. Is this the next spoke? This is the next spoke. Please assemble them one by one. Be careful not to tighten them too much. Tighten them just enough so they won't come loose. For beginners, we recommend using a screwdriver. Assemble it according to the pattern. The basic pattern has been completed. Check the valve direction. Now, rotate the hub with the spokes installed in the opposite direction of the valve hole to create a cross pattern. The basic pattern is complete. Check the valve position and turn the hubs. Fourth step, flange. B. Fit the spoke outward from the inside. Turn it slightly like this. Install them one by one from the outside like this. B. Fit the spoke outward from the inside. It's a big 700C rim, so a two crosses pattern is probably possible. The 700C spokes are long enough to overlap other spokes. When the bike wheel spokes cross, the last spoke that meets does not simply pass by, but needs to be overlapped and connected to make a sturdy wheel. spokes are very thick, so they just pass by without overlapping. This is the only difference between electric bike and regular bike wheel spoke building. Finally, the fifth step is to install the spoke in flange A outward from the inside. Slide up from the bottom. Install in the empty hole. Overlap while crossing the spokes here. Following the pattern, one cross looks good. Prepare the wheel truing stand. Install the wheel onto the wheel truing stand. Wheel alignment. The method is the same. Align the left, right, center, top, bottom, center, and left, right, center to complete the alignment. Using a spoke wrench, you should be able to determine the start and end of wheel rotation while tightening the nipples. Attach a sticker-like tag to the spoke next to the rim valve hole. To tighten the spoke nipple, turn it clockwise. Tighten all the nipples while leaving a 1 mm spoke thread. It is recommended for beginners to do it by hand. Firstly, we will explain the principle behind adjusting the rim left and right. By tightening the right drive side spoke nipple, the rim will move to the right. Conversely, tightening the left non-drive side spoke nipple will move the rim to the left. It is important to note that over-tightening the left spoke nipple can cause the rim to move too far. Releasing the nipple will cause the rim to move in the opposite direction. In summary, the principle is that the tension power balance of the left and right spokes moves the rim and aligns it to the center. While rotating the wheel in one direction, adjust the left and right spoke nipples once each. Reach about 80% of the target tension. Secondly, let's take a look at how to align the rim up and down. By tightening the peripheral nipples together, the rim will move towards the hub. To move the rim in small increments, tighten or loosen the nipples at least 360 degrees. Loosening the surrounding nipples together will cause the rim to move away from the hub. Vertical alignment of the rim only works when the left and right spoke tensions are adjusted together. Aligning the top and bottom of the rim is time-consuming. Reach about 90% of the target tension. When assembling wheels, the center can become slightly misaligned due to errors in the wheel truing stand. To correct this, a tool called a wheel alignment gauge or centering gauge is used. First, let's set up the dishing tool on the non-drive side. Attach the gauge securely without any gaps. Now, fix the gauge in place. Move the dishing tool to the opposite position. The measurement shows a gap of about 4 millimeters. To calculate the rim displacement distance, 4 millimeters division by 2 equals 2 millimeters rim displacement distance. Now, we only need to move the rim by 2 millimeters. Adjust the position of the rim by tightening the left nipple once and loosening the opposite nipple once. This will allow the rim to move without changing the tension of the spokes. Before starting the job, label the spokes and check the starting and ending positions to ensure accuracy. Start the inspection again from the beginning. There should be no gap on the drive side, and if the measurement distances on both sides are equal, the rim is perfectly centered. During the process, using a dishing tool can save time. Check if the spoke tension is similar overall by hand. If you have a tension meter, you can use it as well. Once again, align the wheel vertically and horizontally to reach the target tension of 100%. Align with an error of 0.5 millimeters or less up, down, left, and right. The wheel alignment job has been done excellently.
Perfect,
right.
Success.
Installing the rim tape. Installing the tape becomes easier when you place a wrench on the valve hole. Subscribing, liking, and commenting provide significant support for video production. Thank you for watching.